Hey there. So today we have another review. This is a beer courtesy Pariah. Really weird. So they sent me obviously a box. Congratulations to you guys for a second location in Baltimore. But they sent me a box with like, they sent me three beers and then they sent me another box like a few days to like less than a week later, I think. Hey, thank you. Appreciate it. This one's brewed out of the Baltimore location. Really cool. This one is very fresh, less than a month fresh, and I probably received it 3 weeks fresh, something like that. Anyway, ultraviolet colors, hazy double IPA. We're 5 years old, so 5 years anniversary beer? Maybe. Ultraviolet colors. Let's not try to read the label too much. I always like digging into these. Hazy double IPA, 8.3. Ooh, big guy. Hey-o. Let's see how they've dialed in their process in the Maryland location to make a hazy beer. Do I have this too warm? No, this one should be nice and cool. They even have recommendation, 38 to 45. Wow, they enjoy it real cold. Or fridge temp. Or mostly fridge temp. Beer's pretty nice. Comes in a wonderful kind of like deep gold color, full on haze of that one. Obviously, you saw really beautiful head curation on that guy. Interesting. Cheers. Ooh, a little stinky, huh? A little stinky. What is that? I didn't use anything weird to wash this glass, huh? Not super explosive, but what the hell is going on over there? Rocco? All right, sorry. It never stops around here. It never stops. For your dads and pet lovers out there. Anyway. Okay. Yeah, I hope this is a good time. So this one has really nice levity to it, despite being 8.3%. Not as sludgily sweet as the Widowmaker that I just reviewed. Yeah, has for immediate reminders from here. Hop Butcher. Really nice kind of like juicy sweetness up front. Sorry, scratch that. That means nothing. It's like a candied, almost like fruit punch sweetness. That's what it's like. It has this kind of like Sunny D, almost like not real fruit juice, but like, you know, like, I mean, right? There's actual juice in Sunny D, right? But anyway, it's like a manufactured kind of like concentrated tropical / citrusy kind of character up front. Wow. Nice and sweet, but also like, you know, tangerines, pineapple juice. The beer has a nice little bit of like light grainy character in the middle. Pale canvas of malt base, you know, wheat, white bread. A little bit of like, what is that? Chalkiness, yeah, chalkiness on the back end. Quite drinkable, 8.3, yeah. I also notice a nice smack of this kind of intense rosy floral character that I get from some of these New England IPAs. Pretty good, pretty good. I mean, a little bit of alcohol in the finish, but like, man, this is dangerous. I would say chill this at 38. I mean, I definitely have it warm in 38, but chill at like 38 or even lower. Bottle share of this guy is dangerous. Really nice kind of fruit punch, fruit drink kind of flavors up front. A little bit tropical, nice dryness to it. The floral action I find a little bit distracting, sort of like, it's a little bit like drinking rose water / like, maybe not orange blossom, maybe something like orange, like you, if you've had rose water, orange blossom water, like they're very intense, like almost like chewing on a bag of potpourri, right? Anyway, what do they got here? Yeah, so New Zealand and American. So I mean, I should have mentioned it, but I would have guessed that there's maybe some New Zealand going on around here. There's just a little bit of thiol heavy thing that sort of hits up front when I taste this. Maybe it's not only just like Sunny D and fruit drink. It's got like a little, maybe a little bit of like white grape like drink to it. Yeah. Yeah. And as I drink it more, it's like the floral elements also like pull into this kind of like methane-y kind of like dank character. It's like thiol-y. It's like, A little bit gasoline-y, yeah. So, let me see. I mean, when I smelled something weird, like, I should have probably guessed. Some people call it catty. I find catty you know, sometimes in the West Coast beers, and it could happen in hazies. So, like, when I smell some stinky, I should have, like, probably picked up on that. It certainly got a stink to it. Like, ooh. It's, I mean, it's not isovaleric, right? Those are cheesy hops. Nope. Maybe. I'm not really super familiar with isovaleric, so. Even though, like, I had to study for it. Which is a all flavor produced by aged hops and Brett contamination that causes like Parmesan-y sweat sock kind of like stinky kind of character, which actually probably could maybe like lead towards here. But again, I have to learn isovaleric like actually out of flavor spikes instead of just guessing what it is. A little bit of stinkiness going on here. That could be the thals. That could be maybe the hops. Who knows? I assume they're using fresh hops. Pretty good. Good example. 94 of this Pariah Ultraviolet colors. Very good stuff. Nice. Again, thank you so much, Pariah. Congrats on the second location. Great stuff. Cheers. Later. Hey. 94. But they're saying grist heavy in oats. Concentrated orange, I definitely got that. Cantaloupe, mango, fruit stripe, gum. There you go. That was that kind of like weird free candy thing I was getting. Fruit stripe gum. So they're probably just changing up their yeast character and trying to get that ester profile come in. Cantaloupe, mango, concentrated orange, all that stuff. Again, whoever's writing the descriptors, guys, Pariah, you're doing a great job because I'm finding a lot of matches and hopefully that's good news because if I can match with somebody who's professionally writing them, ideally, that's good news. Until next time, guys. Cheers. Later.